everybody, it's I, Metalhead Weatherman here. Hopefully everyone's doing well today. So in this one, we're going to do the summer outlook here. It's been a while since we've done an update on the summer video. So we're going to go ahead and just kind of take a look and kind of review what we've been dealing with, seeing what the new outlook is. We are anticipating another one coming in soon. So there will be an update probably within the next week or so, depending on how things go with severe weather and tropical season. But in the meantime, looking at things as they stand right now, the above average temperature probabilities are really starting to take over at this point. And if you saw my video the other day in regards to what the weather pattern looks like over the next couple weeks, you're going to see pretty much a similar look throughout most of summer, where the northern plains are going to be the most active in regards to the troughs and ridges. So with that being said, it's not surprising to see the Dakotas, Minnesota, Iowa, and parts of Nebraska in the mix here in regards to equal chances for above or below average temperatures. Some areas that are going to be more concentrated on those above average temperatures, of course, are the Northeast and the Southwest right now. Of course, keep in mind this is over a 3-month average, so while not every day or every week is going to be like this, for the most part, the confidence is pretty substantial that we're going to end up seeing above average temperatures over here for at least a decent span of time here. Then also, if you can even look towards Alaska, and this is somewhat of an indicator of a potentially active weather pattern throughout the summer season, is the below average temperatures over here towards western Alaska and southern Alaska, and then as we go towards the north, above average temperatures. So I do think there are going to be times where we're going to be shifting around a lot with our pattern. So with that being said, that does give me an inkling to maybe there will be some active periods for severe weather. Of course, tropics also going to be a wild card, especially considering the fact that we're still looking for a very active season. So let's go ahead and switch over and take a look at our chances for above or below average precip. And of course, Alaska is pretty busy over here towards the west. We've been seeing a lot of ridging over here, and that's probably going to end up coming back into play. I do think over the course of the next couple weeks, this is going to flip a little bit. So at least towards the northwest, we're going to see a little bit more in the way of precipitation there. Towards the southwest, we usually tend to struggle to get anything to get going over here towards the southern states. This is usually their dry season, so this isn't too far out of the norm, but this does kind of increase the concern for wildfire risk as we go throughout the season. But this doesn't mean that you're not going to get rain every day. In fact, it's been pretty busy over here towards the western high plains, towards Wyoming and Colorado, and some parts of New Mexico, and also southwest Texas. Like eventually, like I said before, pattern's going to change, so we'll have to see how things pan out. It's actually been pretty dry over here towards the eastern half of the U.S., especially towards the southeast. We've been getting popcorn thunderstorms, so on and so forth. But again, like I said before, if the tropics do what they're anticipated to do, this is going to verify a little bit more. Things are going to change in particular over here. Florida in particular has been an area of concern in regards to drought, but it looks like the pattern is already starting to shift even before we get a tropical entity of any kind. But with that, this will only help increase the probabilities of above average precipitation. In any case though, Alaska also, another point of interest, as I mentioned before. So I do think there's going to be times where we end up seeing little flips within the pattern here. So just a reminder to just keep an eye on things as we continue to go forward here. That being said, let's go ahead and look at the models real quick, and we'll take a look at the precipitation probability first, actually. Normally I have this flipped the other way around, but as far as this month is concerned, I do anticipate more in the way of precipitation towards the Ozarks here and over towards the Northwest. Good reflection of what the pattern's kind of currently showing, and we're going to probably continue to see that as we go into the end of June. Then as we get towards July, things start to change a little bit. Pattern kind of flips back to where it was before a little bit more, and we're going to see the West be a little bit more dry. Deep South, Southeast in particular, looks like we're going to have more moisture. I've been seeing a lot of activity over towards the Caribbean lately with the low pressure areas. Really the main thing that's been kind of holding us up in regards to any sort of early tropical development is going to be wind shear. But towards the end of this month, I'm anticipating the wind shear to die down, and thus we're going to start to see an increase in activity most likely. June in particular usually isn't known for being an active month for tropical systems anyway, averaging usually about one storm every 2 years. July is a little bit different, one storm maybe every year on average. Sometimes it can get busy. Wouldn't surprise me if we do get some early activity and end up having much more activity than average considering the forecast for this year. In any case, though, as we go towards August, we see that moisture beginning to increase as we get into the month of August here for the deep south here, also towards the northeast. And out west, it looks like we stay pretty dry. But for the most part, I do think this is going to be due to that shift where we end up seeing a lot more ridging up towards the north here. That ridge is eventually going to kind of kick out to the west a bit. And this is also going to help reduce that wind shear again over the Gulf Coast, which is going to be potentially a sign of trouble here. So if we go over to our temperature map, it's not going to be much of a surprise here. During the summertime, we usually end up seeing a lot of areas that ended up seeing above average temperatures. This is going to be the main thing for June, also July, and even into August. There really aren't any areas in particular that are showing below average temps. It's my last minute alarm that just went off. But in any case, though, as we continue to go forward into August and even into September, pretty much the temperature trend is about the same at this point. So, like I said, we're not really going to see much in the way of below average temperature anomalies until probably, of course, fall and into winter, which we'll get into in another video down the line here. That being said, one thing that I want to show you guys real quick before we finish out this video is, of course, the ridging and the troughing that we'll be looking at in the months ahead here. Keep in mind, this is over a 30-day average, and it's really only showing one particular day at a time. So, of course, this is very much variable. Long-range forecasting, you have to take this look with a grain of salt. But for the most part, we're seeing a lot of predominant ridging going on towards the central part of the country. Over towards the western high plains is where we're going to see more troughing, and I think this is where we're going to end up seeing a little bit more in the way of severe weather over the next month or so in particular. Eventually, that even retreats further up to the north, so it may even allot for some Canadian setup. So who knows, we may have some Canadian streams in the works down the line. But as we continue to go forward here, you can see the ridging starts to really build. It starts really over towards the southeast and then kind of migrates off to the west a bit more, as we mentioned before. This is also going to help keep that Gulf of Mexico moisture flowing. It's also going to weaken the wind shear over here, which is, of course, a key component when it comes to tropical development. So, again, have my concerns with that. But if we take a look at things from a general overview here, it's going to be pretty quiet for storm systems as a whole here, from the looks of it, at least from this vantage point. Of course, like I said, we're looking 90 days out. Typically, most of the forecast videos I do, we barely even look 16 days out. So, that being said, we need to be very watchful in the weeks and months ahead here for sure. But make sure you guys stay tuned. We'll be making updates, of course, as we continue to go forward here, and we'll see what happens next. But until then, you guys have an awesome rest of your day, evening, wherever you may be. But it's been Ty, your metalhead weatherman, signing off so I can get ready for work here.